We have to have oil in our engines, of course, to eliminate the friction of all the various metal parts inside there as they rub together. Probably understand the circulation of the oil a little better if we have a look at the AA's book of the car. The engine's oil supply is housed down in the sump at the bottom of the engine. Now, from here, the oil is then pulled up through the oil pump. The oil is then forced through the oil filter, from where the new and clean engine oil is distributed to the various working parts of the engine. And finally, having done its lubrication job, it runs back down to the sump again for the process to be repeated. Well, not unnaturally with all this activity, the oil does tend to become less effective and so needs to be changed. But before you do that, it really is important to warm the car engine up so it reaches the normal working operating temperature. And this really greatly accelerates draining. We've been warming this one up for some time, so the oil should be really liquid. Oh yes, and don't forget to remove the oil filler cap from up there, because that'll help the air to get into the engine and speed up the oil when it comes out. Of course, most of you are unlikely to be blessed with a proper garage pit like this, but for the television camera and the cameraman that's bringing you this picture, it certainly helps. Of course, the main thing is to get plenty of room, because you may need a fair amount of leverage to release the drain plug. They can be often a little bit reluctant to move. Use the right spanner to do this, and if necessary, jack the car up in the air. This one's fortunately not too stiff. Of course, you are going to need to have the car as level as possible afterwards, and that is so that you can drain all the oil out of the sump pan. The next obstacle is what you're going to catch the old oil in. You can use an old washing up bowl or a can with the top cut out of it, an old oil can, the side that is. Or best of all, I would have thought, is to use a special container. Various ones available like this. This is a can with a depression in the top and its own little drain hole. Because you want to catch all the oil, it's very messy clearing it up, and not very popular at home too. Okay, on with the job. Final release of the drain plug, and out will come the oil. Thing to watch out here, and that is that you remember that the angle that the oil pours out does tend to vary, as you will see. There it goes, pouring out over there. Keep your eye on it the whole time. That's fairly important, because that angle will change as the oil level goes down. Pouring away there. With a bit of luck, it'll start to do it almost automatically. But the worst snag with this oil draining business is what you're going to do with the old oil afterwards. Now, don't be tempted to slip out at midnight and pour it down the drain. That's illegal. Also, don't pour it on the garden too, because it'll find its way into the drain sooner or later, that's for sure. And the other point, of course, is to take it, ideally, to the local council tip, and they will dispose of it for you, or the garage where you buy your new oil. They can't really refuse, if you're buying the new oil, to get rid of your old oil. Okay. When you're putting the drain plug back, finally, be very careful you don't over-tighten it and strip the thread actually in the sump pan. These tend to be a little bit fragile. You don't want to put too much effort into that. Finally draining out all the sludge too. Garages have suction devices these days to speed up the oil change process, but frankly it isn't really as good as draining it out like this, because you are at least getting rid of all the sludge at the same time. Okay, that's just about it. We'll put the plug in like so. If there's a washer underneath the drain plug, make really sure that that goes back, because that is there for a purpose, and that is there to cushion the tension and make sure you get a really oil-tight job. Every other oil change, you ought to change the oil filter too. Here it is on this engine up here. If this becomes clogged, then of course the oil will be bypassing it and will be unfiltered, thus increasing the amount of engine wear. You often have to make some sort of a tourniquet up to help unscrew the filter. It's a cartridge type on this one. More and more popular, increasingly used on cars, replacing the replaceable element type. This one, the whole unit is changed. Beware when you take it off, full of oil, remember, up to about a pint. There it is. In this case, we throw away the old filter completely, replacing it with a new one. Screws on, as I say. Beware though, the threads here, you want to be careful you don't cross those. And also, if a new sealing ring is supplied with the filter, make sure you use it. This one's fairly idiot-proof, like it's attached there permanently. Screw on the new filter, and also check in your vehicle's handbook for the sump capacity for your particular car. This Escort, including the filter, remember, about 5.5 pints. And away with the old oil, not down the drain. Back to the garage where we get the new oil. Adhere to the recommended grade for your car. Check the handbook for this, although most cars these days seem quite happy on a 2050 multigrade. Buy it in as larger quantities you can. It's certainly a better buy that way. A gallon can seems to be the best, and shop around. The price varies quite enormously. Now, when you come to pouring the oil, probably best to use a measured container, measured jug such as this, because that way you're not going to overfill the engine, and also, of course, you're not going to pour it all over the engine either. You see, as the servicing intervals for modern cars get longer, therefore, the servicing becomes more important, and that includes the oil changing.
I think we're not actually clear on that other...